Hello and welcome. In this video series, we're going to cover some fundamental AWS tagging concepts using Terraform. My name is Derek Morgan, and I am a DevOps and Infrastructure as Code course creator at morethancertified.com. And I'm here courtesy of my friends at cloudforecast.io to help you get your AWS resources tagged properly and efficiently with Terraform. So let's get started. In this video, we're going to refactor the code from the previous video into modules. We're then going to utilize some Terraform function magic to validate that the proper tags are present. If you haven't completed the previous video, you can always clone the code from that video using the repository link provided. All right, so the first thing I want to do is refactor this whole thing into modules. So what I want to do first is just create a new folder, and we'll just call this S3-bucket, just like so. Within that folder, I'm going to create a new file, main.tf, and let's go ahead and create another file, variables.tf, just like so. Now, first up, what I'm going to do is within the variables.tf file, let's go ahead and specify a tags variable. So what we're going to do is use variable tags, just like so, and then just open and close some braces. And that's going to be a type of map of strings, just like so. So go ahead and let's save that. Now let's head back to our root main.tf. Feel free to add comments to the top if you feel like you might get lost. Just like so, root main.tf. And now I'm going to open our S3 bucket main.tf and S3 bucket main.tf just to give us a little reminder. I'm going to open this in another window, just like so. And then I'm going to take one of our S3 buckets here and that random ID. I'm going to Control X to cut that and paste that in here. So now that I've done that, I'm going to keep this resource the same here. And then we're just going to take a look, and we've got a bucket here, and we're going to need to change that name. We're going to want that name to be whatever team is being utilized. So if you look back at our tags, you can see we have a team right here within our tags. So what I can do is actually use interpolation syntax here and use var dot tags, and then we'll access the team attribute of our tags, just like so. And close that interpolation brace right there. So what we're doing is we're referencing the tags provided, and we're accessing the team attribute to name our bucket. So if the team is finance, it will be a finance bucket. As you can see, we've got these tags hard-coded here. We don't want that. Go ahead and remove that, and we're just going to add var.tags, just like so. So we're going to specify the tags that we want to use in our modules from main.tf. They'll then be processed here and initialized with our tags variable, and then passed in right here. So as you can see, we'll need to pass in that map. So let's head back over to our root main.tf. Let's go ahead and reference that module. So I'm going to delete this entirely, and we're going to reference our module. Module, and we'll just call this first one our finance bucket, just like so. Let's open and close some curly braces. Let's just give it a count of one right now. Source equals dot slash S3 dash bucket, just like so. And then here's where we pass in the tags. So tags equals, and then we just pass in our team equals finance, and our service equals S3, just like so. Remember that default tag is already set, so we're not going to pass that in. So what it's going to do is pass in this map of tags as a tags variable, which will be initialized here and passed in. And then, of course, it will access that team attribute to give us our bucket name. So just know if this is a little confusing, you could just name this tags map or really anything you wanted, as long as it matches here within the variables.tf And then, of course, here, var.whatever you're looking for. All right, so now that we've done that, let's go ahead and run a Terraform init to install this module. All right, there we go. Successfully initialized. Let's go ahead and run a Terraform plan. All right, fantastic. We've got two resources to add. One, of course, is the random ID. The previous random ID is going to be destroyed, and we've got two buckets being created. Now, yours may look a little bit different depending on how you ended up on the previous video. All right, so we've got our finance bucket. Looks like our tags are all there. As you can see, tags all includes the environment that we set as a default. The tags, of course, do not include that. And the name of the bucket will be computed as soon as we run the apply. So let's run a Terraform apply, auto approve, just like so. I'm going to head into my S3 console here, run a refresh there. And as you can see, we now have the finance bucket 33618, which, of course, as you remember, to get that finance bucket, we referenced that tag in the team. All right, perfect. So let's do one more. Let's go ahead and just copy this and paste it down below. And we'll call this our DevOps bucket, just like so. The team, of course, is going to be DevOps here. So now let's run a Terraform init. All right, perfect. Let's run a Terraform plan. Okay, looks like everything's good there. And let's run a Terraform apply, auto approve. All right, perfect. So if I head back over to my S3 management console and refresh, as you can see, we now have our DevOps bucket with a different random ID. Perfect. So now how are we supposed to verify that our team and service tags exist? It's pretty easy to see if this tag was supposed to be there, if it's added into the provider as a default tag. But right now, we need to make sure that these tags include our team and service. So let's go and take a look at some variable validation. So what we can do is add a validation block, open and close some braces there. We then need to define a condition, just like so, equals, and this condition needs to equal true one way or another. So what we want to do is ensure that these two tags exist within this map. So let's go and take a look at how to do that. I'm actually going to just comment this out right now. And let's run Terraform console, just like so. All right, so right now what we've got is we want to ensure that the keys team and service exist within our tags variable, which is a map. So let's take a look here. First, let's just see how to access the keys that we need only and not the full dictionary. So what we can use is the keys function. So if we use the keys function, and let's say team equals finance, just like so, and service equals S3. Go ahead and wrap that up. If we hit enter, as you can see, we now have the two keys. So what we want to ensure is that these two keys exist. So to do that, we can use the contains function. So if we use contains and then pass in the list of what we want to check against, env and team, just like so, which of course would be these two items here. And then we pass in the item that we want to check. And in this case, that could be env. As you can see, that's true. And as you see, I screwed up my tags here. We are looking for team and service, not environment and team, but that's okay. I think you get the point there. So now let's see if we can figure out kind of how to access each one of these keys and verify that it is in the list. So what we can do is we can actually use a for statement. So for t in team and service, just like so, let's just print t right now. As you can see, we've got team and service, so that's how we can use a for loop to access each one of these. So now what we need to do is utilize all of this to check to see what is contained within that list. So we use for t in team and service. We then add a colon there, and then we use our contains function. So contains, keys, and then let's pass in what our tag block would look like. Team equals finance, and service equals S3, just like so. We then check the keys, team, and service to ensure it's within this list here, T, and then let's close that. As you can see, we've got two trues, perfect. But this validation is only expecting one true. So what we can do is I'm just going to copy this here with a control C, and we're just going to use the alltrue function, paste that in just like so between parentheses, and we are now down to one true. So this will verify that team and service are specified in our tags. I know that was a lot, but it's a pretty cool trick. So I'm just going to copy this from right here to save a little bit of typing. Control C to get out of the Terraform console. I'm going to uncomment this here, and within the condition, let's go ahead and paste. But of course, we need to change a couple of things here. First up, we are expecting team and service, so that's fine. And instead of passing in the tags manually, we will just pass in var.tags, just like so. All right, so now let's go ahead and add our error message. And that error message does require some grammar. Make sure you do start with a capital and end with a period. We'll just say, please specify the team and service tags, just like so. And now let's run a Terraform plan, and hopefully it works. All right, it is looking good right now. Let's go back and change one of these to, we'll just say, teams. Let's head back over here and run another Terraform plan. And as you can see, please specify the team and service tags. So it failed because this was not team like is expected. All right, so that is all for this video. Feel free to go ahead and run an apply to make sure everything works, or run a destroy like I'm going to do. And then go ahead and complete this video, and please join us on the next one as we dive a little bit deeper into this deployment.